This week on Music Surgery with Dr. Bob, we'll be cutting into and diagnosing shock rock. Music Surgery with Dr. Bob, where we cut into all kinds of musical topics. We diagnose them, we remedy them, and we stitch them back up. All right, Sumner, that's enough of the stupid vocal effect thing. It's bad. It's like Kiss meets the Phantom. Look it up. How do guys like Brian Warner, Vincent Furnier, and Chaim Weitz become famous? They become someone else. Let's get out the scalpel, cut into these guys and a few others to really get the full effect of how they shock the world into buying their music, their swag, and filling up arenas to watch them do that thing they do.
Ring around the rosy pocket full of posies.
It's okay, Sumner. It's all pretend. It's all pretend. Okay, so now that we're freaked the hell out, let's take a closer look at the genius and the concept behind these acts and how you may be surprised that in some ways they aren't at all that different than other artists that market themselves to shock the world. What's the first thing you think of when you hear the name Elvis? Handsome sex symbol that shakes his hips that my mother-in-law has naughty thoughts about. What's the first thing you think of when you hear the name Shania Twain? Beautiful, confident, great belly button. What's the first thing you think of when you hear the name Taylor Swift? Cute girl that plays on Poor Me. I've been dumped by guys, but now I get the last laugh because I'm huge. What's the first thing you think of when you hear the name Justin Bieber? Dates models, drives sick cars, and lives like a rich rock star. What's the first thing you think of when you hear the name Billie Eilish? Dark brooding and brings out my dark side and justifies my teenage angst. And what's the first thing you think of when you hear the name Gene Simmons? Fire-breathing, blood-spitting demon that's had sex with lots of women. So what are we getting at here? We're getting at this. Notice that every description we gave had nothing to do with music. It's all about image. The second you finish writing your song and recording it in the studio and it's coming out for the world to hear, you've just left the music business and entered the entertainment business. All of these stars have figured out ways to sell their songs and their persona and how to shock the public into giving them our attention. Almost any successful artist you can think of has a certain attachment to them besides how they play or how they sing. It may be incredible costumes, incredible lumberjackishness, incredibly purple, incredible dancing, or incredible booties. The point we're trying to make here is this. With everyone's attention being grabbed from every direction, Xbox, iPhone, YouTube, Netflix, whatever, songs aren't enough. How are you going to shock them into paying attention to you? Am I saying sell out? No way. I'm saying sell. Once your song is done and it sounds like a hit and all of your friends think you're killing it, remember this. What's your it factor? If no one has heard your song yet, but they've just met you, what is it about you they're going to tell everyone? And how are you going to sell that to shock the world? At the end of every episode, we have a segment called Hidden Gems, where we tell you about a record, an artist, a song, etc. that you may not know about. This week's Hidden Gem is the journey of a man that had to deal with the devil himself. This demon slayer went all the way to Spain to deal with Diablo, to beat him with unparalleled speed and technique, to race with the devil on Spanish highway. Even if you aren't into jazz fusion, you can listen to this and know that guitarist Al Dimeola is next level. Along with Lenny White on drums, Anthony Jackson on bass, Barry Miles and Jan Hammer on keys, and Mingo Lewis on congas, who sounds possessed by the devil himself. They rocked the jazz world in this race long before Charlie Daniels duked it out with the devil down in Georgia. No one knows what was quite at stake here, but legend has it that Al won the battle, and apparently wasn't sharing any of the spoils with the band. Race with the Devil on Spanish Highway, off the album Elegant Gypsy, is this week's amazing hidden gem. Well, that about does it for this episode. I think we've successfully cut into, diagnosed, and remedied the topic of shock rock, and perhaps how it's not just descriptive of the rock freaks, but descriptive of all entertainers that shock the world. Thanks for watching Music Surgery with Dr. Bob. I'll see you the next time the doctor's in. With five ex-wives, finances are tough around the doctor's mansion. Please hit subscribe below to help out. I thank you, my attorney thanks you, and all 16 of my children will thank you this Christmas. Thanks for watching Music Surgery with Dr. Bob. It's okay, Sumner. It's all pretend. It's all pretend.